Hello and happy 2024. This video is a commentary about Ottawa's vacant unit tax program, and it's basically all going to be quotes from Randall Denley of the Ottawa Citizen. This is not my writing. I only wish I had written this, and kudos to Randall Denley. I thought it was a great article. So I'm going to be taking excerpts from it. And how it starts is, why stop at the vacant unit tax? Ottawa should introduce a CRAP program, C-R-A-P, and it stands for Communal Residential Action Plan. And Randall wrote this on December 27th in the Ottawa Citizen. So I'll get right into it. It's predictable that a handful of cranks would be upset by the City of Ottawa's totally reasonable and utterly judicious audit of compliance with its brilliant vacant unit tax program. These malcontents think that it is quite enough, or perhaps even too much, for the city to demand annual proof that owners do, in fact, live in their own homes. Imagine that. These complainers have to catch up with the times, writes Randall. Surely in Ottawa, of all places, we must realize that each and every government rule is meant to be vigorously enforced. That's why the city is randomly auditing 1,525 homeowners and demanding that they produce extra documentation to prove that they do live in their own houses. Now I'm going to skip over some of it and continue on with, now, to encourage people to rent out these vacant properties, the city will eventually hit them with a tax penalty equivalent to 1% of the value of their property. Even filing late could cost you $250, and if you only pretend to live in your own house, that's a $10,000 penalty. How much more encouraging can the city get? If there's a problem with a vacant unit tax, is that it doesn't do nearly enough to solve the city's vexing shortage of affordable housing. Surely the city can do more. So, building on the success of the VUT, it's time for the Communal Residential Action Plan, or CRAP. Think of all those empty nesters out there living in their big suburban houses with spare bedrooms galore. Now think about the 12,000 people in Ottawa who are on the city social housing list hoping for larger, cheaper accommodation. So I think you can see where this is going. Randall's very wise. Instead of rattling around in that big house all alone, the 90-year-old widow, you can read about that in the Ottawa Citizen too. This is a lady who is having problems navigating filing her VUT. 90-year-old widow could enjoy the company of an entire family who could move into her house and they could live communally. Communal living, we've recently been told by city officials, is an exciting idea. The city itself would supply the new tenants, so how easy could it be, right? Well, not tenants really, in the usual sense. Perhaps call them co-living partners would be a better term. Now, some might oppose this approach, but a tax penalty of 1% of the property's value would surely encourage anybody to open up all the empty bedrooms that they have in their house to let in these other people to live with them communally. It's not just making co-living mandatory. The idea is simply too good to be ruined by stuffy reactionaries who believe that because they own their own house, they should have the right to do with it, or they should have the right to decide how it's used. This is just selfish. This is old-fashioned thinking. As the city has already demonstrated with the VUT and rules restricting short-term rentals, how you use your property is up to the government, not you. Don't be so silly. It's not up to you how you use your house. Now, the new CRAP plan would be applauded by progressive city councillors and their supporters across the city. It would take equity and inclusion to a whole new level. Why should you live in a home that's larger than what you need when another family has to put up with inadequate space? That's not equitable. What could be more inclusive than having others right in your own home? This is Ottawa's chance to be on the cutting edge of a housing policy. With the new VUT CRAP plan, we would be the envy of the world. So that's what Randall wrote. Now, just a couple of quick thoughts of my own. I thought this was a great tongue-in-cheek article by Randall Denley. It was hilarious to read how many people left comments at the end of the article who thought he was serious. That was as funny as the article was. So if you have a chance to look in the Ottawa Citizen and read that, go ahead. Now, I still can't get over the fact that we have the VUT. It is a serious government intrusion and overreach tax grab into our private lives. If someone owns their own home, they pay their taxes, they pay the utilities, it's no damn business of Mark Sutcliffe and company if that person chooses to travel for 7 months of the year. Speaking of which, I'm rather disappointed that Mr. Sutcliffe would permit this to happen in our city, as he ran on a ticket of balanced judgment, and he's also a businessman. Rather than making 99% of homeowners work to declare that they live in their own house, for God's sakes, the make another random 1,500 home and make another 1,500 homeowners jump through additional bureaucratic hoops, why not target the minuscule number of people who they're really after? All right, go for the minority instead of everybody else. So how you target them? For example, Hydro Ottawa is owned by the city. The City of Ottawa also provides our water sewer services. As such, they can easily determine if a house has not used hydro or not used water in a given period of time. That would strongly indicate that it's a vacant house, right? Or whatever the threshold would be, such as if a house only used like 5% of the amount of water that an average house did, or 5% of the hydro of an average house, that could be indicative that it's vacant. I know some people would squawk about, this is a breach of privacy. You can't look at my water sewer bills. Well, the city is very intrusive as it is, so why not just make it mandatory that in order to receive the city service, if you want city hydro, if you want city water sewer, that you have to be in agreement to allow the city to determine your utility usage and contact you if it's not being used. The city investigators can then look into these few properties instead of forcing hundreds of thousands of others to be subjected to this left-wing purge in order to make themselves feel good. So anyhow, Randall, great article, really enjoyed it. Thank you.